Breathe in. Breathe out. I am in complete control of my body and mind, but today I'm gonna show you how to use your mind to control someone else's body. Gianni!
What?
Today I've got Gianni DeCenzo from Cobra Kai. Today I'm gonna show you some science experiments that will actually make it look like you have mind control over someone else.
Bro.
You're gonna steal my free will. I literally can't stop it from happening.
Yeah, no free will.
Okay, let's do it.
Before we get started, I want to cover a couple things. A lot of people think that the brain and the mind are the same thing, and they're similar, but they're different. The brain has to do with the physical object in your head. That's the 80 billion neurons that are firing off to give you functionality and movement.
Okay.
But the mind has to do with conscious thought. That's the idea of sending the signal and thinking about stuff. Now, a lot of people think that the mind's in control of the body, and that's true for voluntary movement. But there's also involuntary movement. So if you touch something hot and you pull your hand away without thinking about it, that's an involuntary response. So it makes you wonder, what's really in charge? Is it the body, the mind, the brain, or in this case, me? Place your hands together. Make sure you have two hands and they're equal sizes, right?
I have two hands.
Okay, great. Now take your right handed.
Yeah.
Okay, take your right hand, stare at your right hand, and focus on your right hand and imagine it just expanding and growing.
Okay. All right?
And just stare at your hand and just stretch it out and just go grow.
Grow.
Like really focus on it growing right in front of you.
Okay.
All right, now take your hand and place them together and your hand's larger than the other.
What are you doing to me, man?
I need you to put your hands flat out like this. All right, now a little bit higher if you would, like this. Now, I want you to make fists with both hands. I'm gonna turn around. I want you to put one of those hands behind your back. Okay, you got it?
Yeah.
All right, cool. All right, so that one's behind your back. Go ahead and let go of this one.
Okay.
All right, I'm gonna draw a marker, or mark on my hand. We'll do,
okay.
An X, okay?
It's an X.
We're actually gonna pass this through your body.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
Right through my body?
Yeah, go ahead and open your hand.
Okay. Wait. This marks the spot. Wait.
I want you to take your finger.
Okay.
I want you to bend your middle finger towards the X. Perfect.
Okay.
Place it on the floor like this.
Okay.
All right, now here comes the power of mind control.
Okay.
I'm going to point to a finger and say, can you lift that finger? And you try to lift it. And then I'm going to tell you when you can't lift a finger and you won't be able to do it.
Okay.
All right, here we go. You'll be able to lift this finger.
I can lift this finger. All right.
You'll be able to lift this finger.
Still right.
All right, put it back.
Okay.
Now, focus. I'm going to remove the strength of your hand, and now you won't be able to lift this finger. Go ahead and lift it.
Jason, you know for a fact I can't.
Go ahead and flip your hand over. Between your middle finger and your ring finger are actually connected. So if this is folded like this, there's no way you would be able to lift that finger in general. Mind control, 1 point. How do you feel about the idea of mind over matter?
I mean, honestly, with my character Demetri, it's pretty important because, you know, he's not the strongest guy in the world. He tends to like to take a flag football approach to things, but his mind, that's where he excels.
It's all about heart.
Yeah,
it's all about heart.
It's about the heart.
Whatever, Cruella. I am 101% in love.
All right, Gianni, for this one, I want you to put your arm out and have it barely touch the wall, if you would, like that, right?
Okay.
All right, you can barely touch it. Now, okay. I want you to take your arm and place it up to your head like this.
This one?
This one, place it up to your head like this.
Okay.
Take your other hand and massage the muscle right here.
Okay.
Just really intensely massage this muscle. Now, we're gonna do this for about 20 seconds. I'm gonna convince you that your arm is shorter. Without leaning forward, just extend your arm.
What have you done to me? I didn't sign up for this.
A lot of people think that by massaging your muscles right here, you're actually causing the muscles to contract, which
okay.
is actually making your arm appear smaller. But it also
okay.
could be a power of suggestion, which is when I first extended your arm, you were barely touching the wall. It
okay.
actually tilted your body a little bit. So when you went back to massage your arms, I didn't give you that gesture. And so by giving that power of suggestion right
yeah.
before you did it, by saying, I'm gonna shrink your arm,
yeah.
when your arm relaxes, you're back here.
Well, I'm very susceptible to magic. What the heck? I pride myself on having long limbs.
No worries, we got more to do. All right, let's go with this.
Oh, good.
Just take your hands and go ahead like this. Separate them. Put a gap. Extend your fingers open like this, okay?
Okay.
And while you're doing that, looking at these fingers. And as I close my fingers, your fingers start to close. Even if you don't want them to, they're gonna close.
I literally can't stop it from happening.
So much like the constant phenomenon, when you have those constricted muscles, your hands are doing exactly what they're supposed to be doing. You've got your hands are super tight and you're going like this. Now, your hands are actually more comfortable like this than they are like this. So as you relax, your hand is closing on its own. Now I just need to pretend like I have some superpower over it, but really, your muscles are just doing what they're supposed to be doing.
Who knew I had muscles?
What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hold the board like this, and I want you to take your arm and I want you to push up on this board as hard as you can. And we're gonna do that for about 20 seconds. So, ready? Go, as hard as you can.
I have the power! Whoa!
Now, what we're gonna do is when I stop, I want you to relax your arm.
Okay.
And it should cause your arm to start rising on its own.
Okay.
All right, so ready? 3, 2, 1, relax your arm.
Wait, that is crazy. No strings.
Now, if you don't have a wooden board, you just need something stationary. So you can use a door jamb or just a wall, put your arm against it like this, and try to push out for 20 seconds. If you're in a door jamb, you can do it inside the door jamb just with both arms, and it works both ways. Pretty cool. So now that you've seen science do some awesome things, we're gonna use a little bit of technology to show you how far we can take this with real mind control.
It's a dangerous combination.
You know, when you wanna move a muscle, your brain is sending a signal through your motor cortex down through your spine into your muscles. And that electrical signal is running through your muscles. This device allows me to see that this signal is coming through. So if I were to flex, you can see the LEDs, that's saying it recognizes the signal that my arm is sending to it.
Okay.
These electrodes are actually picking up that signal, telling this tens unit to turn on, which we're then sending that signal to his ulnar nerve, which controls these three fingers. And we're gonna move your arm with my arm.
So you're gonna steal my free will?
Yeah, no free will. Ready?
I'm ready. Oh my God. Oh God.
Ta-da!
Ta-da!
You're not doing it on
your own. No, I'm not! I swear, oh my God! It doesn't hurt, but I just feel like it's like moving on its own.
We've got you wired up to my arm.
Okay.
The student becomes the master.
I'm gonna enjoy this.
Okay, here we go, here we go.
This is so weird. This makes no sense. I mean, it does, it's science, but still, it can make you do anything. Air guitar. Does this mean I get a point now, or?
I hope you enjoy our goofy experiments that you can now try on your friends. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Comment down below. Down below. Like, follow, subscribe.
Watch.
Oh my God.
That's really amazing.
I can just do it forever.
I can only do this.
Oh,
it's not really a pop, it's just actually a trip. DIY neuroscience. What could go wrong with that?
Nothing.